Hello and welcome to this Shaper 3D tutorial. My name is Daniel and today we are going to take a look into the newly updated section view, which will highlight interferences between objects. And also we take a look into the updates in the view section in order to save some views and save us valuable time while working on this model. All right, let's jump in and see what we are working with. So this is a model of a phone charger, and you can see that I rotated those elements, and it's quite not a complex movement, but we have some axes, some hinges that are moving, and we need to make sure that everything is working fine before sending it off to production. So let's see what's going on inside. From the outside, it looks very simple, but let's go into the model by turning on our section view and just scrolling through. And we can see that with the section view enabled, we are seeing a lot more of the complexity of this model. So our section view is highlighting all these parts of the model. So the different parts receive different colors. So now it's very easy to differentiate between those elements. And so when we scrub through, we can check and see if we have any interferences within these parts. Already I can see a red highlight here on the bottom. And also if you check closely, we have an interference here as well on the top. So we have to remember these and then just continue scrolling, and we can see a bit more red popping up. So that gives us a good indication of the elements that are intersecting with each other. So we definitely need to resolve those issues before sending it off to prototyping or even production. So let's try and solve these interferences first. Let's go to the front view. And since we have those two parts of the model that we need to work on, it makes it easy to go back and forth into these views by saving those views that we need more often. So let me zoom in here and let's go over to our view section here. And under saved views, we can save this particular camera view and go back into this position quite easily. And the same thing here with the lower part. So now we can then switch back and forth and check into these views during our work. So now I can go to our views and then just click on view one and view two, and we can quickly and easily switch between those. All right, next we need to check what is causing these interferences. And in order to do so, let's go back into our history and then right click on the last part before our rotation of the different elements. So right click, insert a breakpoint here, and you can see that we now have a compact version of this model, so a closed version, and we can see these interferences clearly as well. So now let's find the sketch that defines these elements. So if I remember correctly, it's sketch number 6. So let's go in here, click normal to sketch, or click on our views and even go to our view 2 that we just saved earlier. So now we can see that we have defined the tab that houses our axis, and we just didn't give the lower part enough space in order to move freely. So let's just increase this distance now to 2 millimeter. And we can already see that we now have a lot more space and a lot less interferences, even though I can still see some red here. So let's keep going and maybe try 2.2 millimeters. And that completely gets rid of the red highlights. And that tells me that there's now no interference whatsoever. So this looks perfect. This looks really good. But I think we remember that we had another interference all the way in the beginning. In order to check this, we need to again go back in our history all the way down after our rotations. And we can also, or we need to also change the section plane. So let's scrub back where we first saw these interferences. So now you can see those two, one on the top and one on the bottom. So again, we need to see what are the parts that define these elements. So let's think this through, what we can do in order to remove these interferences. So of course we could cut these corners, but that literally would mean cutting corners. Let's think of another strategy or another way in order to get rid of these interferences. And I think the way to do it is just to increase the height of this tab in order to just push this out a little bit in order to avoid these intersections. So let's find the sketch that we used to define the height of this tab. Again, I think it's easiest to just go back into our history, insert the breakpoint, and then check before our rotation. Now we can go up and see and find the feature that we used in order to define this distance. So this basically defines the height of this tab. The good thing is that I set up this model, so any changes I make to this part here is also being mirrored down to this part below, since this is just a mirror image and the same geometry as the one that we are working on right now. So let's just increase this to 4 millimeters, and you can see everything is updating accordingly. And we can also check with our section view that there's no additional intersections appearing. We can now remove our breakpoint and check these details and see if the issues have been resolved. So let's go to our view 2. I think this looks good. There's no intersections, no highlights, no red. And then also on view 1, we now got rid of all the interferences. So this now doesn't collide with each other. And again, just to make sure, we can go into our section view, just click on the section view plane, and we can now scroll through and see if there's any additional red highlights that mean interferences along our model. But everything looks perfect. So now we made sure that there's no interfering elements and parts, and this model is ready for production. So this is how to use the newly updated section view that highlights interferences in order to easily troubleshoot intersecting elements. Thank you so much for watching, and see you next time.